Oh man, I'd completely forgotten about this. Anybody remember this? You would install the game and you'd get to do like a quiz on Sims facts and have like a little memory matching tile game. That was cool. Except nowadays when you install it on a modern computer with a digital copy, it installs so quickly you don't get to play it. Anyway, this is The Sims 2, frickin' finally. Yes, released in September. The 14th of September in 2004. Holy crap. It's been almost a decade. Well, that's insanity. But anyway, yes, this is the game right here. You start the game up, and it's very much different from The Sims 1. You have a variety of neighborhoods to choose from, and this is just the base game. You know, this is no expansion, no nothing. Three freaking neighborhoods, full neighborhoods, totally different. Pleasant View, Strange Town of Veronaville. Whoa. And you could even make your own friggin' custom neighborhoods right here, based on SimCity 4 maps. This was so friggin' cool. What the frick happened? Anyway, yeah, you can make them right here. It was so easy. You had to learn to play thing. It was so easy. This game was so easy to get into, and you had so much content at the beginning. In fact, let's jump in and get some of that content right now. We're gonna start in Pleasant View. A lot has happened in 25 years. Okay. I think this one takes place somehow on a timeline that's like after The Sims. I don't know, it's before Sims 1. I don't remember. I don't know. There's some sort of timeline thing going on, but, yeah. Alright, this is Pleasant View. It looks quite pleasant. It's got a bridge. And water. All you need for Pleasant View. Yes, there you go. Alright, so there's houses. Yay, as you can see, the game is now completely in 3D. Whoa! Sims 1 was in a locked perspective, isometric view. Although you had 3D models for the Sims themselves. Everything else was just 2D, pre-rendered. And this, on the other hand, everything's 3D. Except for the stuff that's not. Which isn't much. But anyway, yeah, I was always jealous of like the console people that got that console version of The Sims that was all in 3D and stuff. And then finally this came out, and I'm like, yes! And then my computer was crap, and I couldn't really play it, and it took for frickin' ever to load or do anything. And I was like, yes, I still have The Sims 2! Who cares if it's slow? But anyway, yeah, here we go. So what can we do here? Well, you can place frickin' decorations right here, just raw! Look how freaking easy that is. You could just get into this game and start screwing around with everything from the get-go. Like, it's so much freaking easier to do than stuff in The Sims 3. It's great. I love it. Who needs these things? I don't know. Nobody does. But I can do them. So, they're now done. This is the nastiest looking town ever. Yeah, let's put some rainbows everywhere. There's gonna be so many freaking rainbows in this place. Rainbows are like mustaches for the sky. And everybody's gonna have a farm on their lot, because that's what I do. Alright, so here we go. We are going to actually play the game now. Are we? Let me check the options, make sure here. Yeah, okay, it looks good. It looks good to me. Oh yeah, a bunch of good stuff as far as music here too. Yeah, well, just a bunch of good stuff, man. From the very beginning. I like that. Oh yeah, you could also do like a recording for the first time within the game, not having to use an external program like Fraps, although that's what I'm doing here. That's a lot of rainbows. Oh my. Anyway, and yes, it had some online features, which, Moment of Silence has now been discontinued, so, no, actually, no Moment of Silence, I don't like those. But you could actually upload everything directly to the Exchange without having to go through any third-party sites or anything like that. It was pretty cool. I like to think of it as maybe sort of a EA response to sites like The Sims Resource and other places that charged money for doing douchey things. But anyway, let's take a look at some houses. All right, that's a good look. Hell of a hacienda. That is a hell of a hacienda right there. Yeah, let's make a what am I making? A city. Let's not. Let's make a family. It's gonna be these guys. What's the family gonna be called? Well, I wonder. It's not gonna be Duke Nukem. We got to start off with the reviewer, because that's me. Yes, we're going to go with the Lazy Game Reviewer. Lazy Game Reviewer. And this, this is another big addition to The Sims. You know, I can't believe it now, but in The Sims 1, you couldn't age up your Sims. Crazy. Well, now you've got 5 distinct life states, ranging from elder, adult, teenager, child, and toddler. Pretty freaking crazy. So yeah, you could do that. Bunch of more body shop options, which we'll get into here in a moment. Skin tones being separate, although it's super, super easy to mod this one. In fact, you had The Sims Body Shop external program that you could mod and, you know, like, make your own clothing and stuff right there. It was so freaking easy to do. Ease of use and tons of ability right from the get-go. That was The Sims 2, and it was amazing. We can completely randomize your sim. Let's see what we get here. That looks nothing like me, but maybe we'll just go with that. I definitely am lighter than that. I'm even whiter than this guy, but whatever. Let's go for that. And you have 2 body shapes. You've got sort of slightly chubby and, fit. No body sliders here, but whatever. Go with that. And, let's see. Let's go with, what did I normally go with? I think I normally went with this or something. Although, good grief, he zoomed in enough. Let's look at that ear. Man, that's a nasty looking ear. I can count the polygons. Let's have some hair. Hair is always a good thing if you don't want your skin exposed on your scalp. Awkward silence. I go with the mohawk just because I don't give a crap right now. And we're going to choose a face. I always like doing this. Just go between all these different extremes and you just, yeah, you see them like. I always like to try to get their, here we go. You can almost see it. Looks like a, I don't even know what. Somebody that had some horrible disease, you know, in between the transitions there, but yeah. So you could deal with all sorts of different starting face styles and then individually do craziness. Man, yeah, this game is fantastic. The fact that you can make the ugliest freaking creatures I've ever seen is, it's wonderful, really. So, yes, there we go. That looks quite acceptable to me. How about, let's see this right here. Let's just do all sorts of extremes because that's what I like. I need nice big anime eyes. That is the only acceptable thing. Lazy Game Reviewer. That's me right here. Why you could make such extremes, I have no friggin' clue. But that was one of the greatest things about this. at least it was for me. You get bored sometimes, you know? You just want to let loose. And, this allows you to do that. That's for frickin' sure. No, we need to go all the way out. Are his teeth coming out of his cheeks? Oh, that's fantastic. I need more of that. There we go. No. Nice and skinny. Yeah! That's me down to a T right there. And let's put some makeup on, some eyelashes, and let's put some of those things, whatever the frick that is. Nice some lipstick there. Nice and there we go. Costume makeup, which I never understood the point of, unless you want to make a guy that looks like this. And in that case, it's ideal. There we go. Oh, yeah. And no glasses, because we want to see everything in its complete natural beauty. some stubble, because why not? And a full beard, because my beard is a heck of a lot longer than that, but whatever. It's as close as it gets. And see, here we have, why do I have 2 in here? I don't remember. Right, here we go. So yeah, I made this in like 5 minutes just with Photoshop and the body shop that comes with the game. I mean, yeah, it's just so freaking easy and approachable to just customize the crap out of this just with the stuff out of the box. That's just, That's great. If The Sims 4 doesn't have this kind of stuff, then I'm going to be kind of disappointed. I equate The Sims 3 to The Sims 1 in a lot of ways, just in the fact, well, at the beginning especially, the fact that it doesn't have as much to it as far as ease of use and being able to just get in there and do your own thing and the amount of stuff that it comes with. I'm really hoping that The Sims 4, they go with more like The Sims 2, you know. The Sims 3 felt kind of like a reboot of the series to me, and let's chew some pants and go with them. Whereas The Sims 4, I think, could be like an improvement on The Sims 3 in pretty much every way. At least that's what I hope it is. So, anyways. Let's do that. Oh, yes. I enjoy food on my balls. So there we go. This is... Okay. And, yes. Silly colors, please. And athletic. I don't care. Now, we also have some personality choices, which is the same exact crap as The Sims 1. You can choose your astrological sign, whoop-de-doo, whatever. And you can choose an aspiration, which is good for some reason. I forget exactly why, but let's go with knowledge, because knowledge is power. And we'll do that. We need to add another person, since we have this doofus. And there's only one choice for this, of course. Alright, and let's go with my pre-made one here that I did in the body shop earlier, and put some clothes on him. Oh, stop zooming in. Get away. Okay, here we go. Let's see. Comes with a nice handy red tank top already in the game. That was always nice. And I made some custom Duke-like pants here. I needed... Oh, man, I forgot to put the belt on there, but that's okay. Whatever. Get a nice pimp suit here, and some nice underwear. Leopard print. There's no other way. PJs. That'll be nice and red one, because Dookie like red. And we'll go with, actually, we'll go with this one, because it looks like it's pointing right to his, balls of steel. And there we go. And, of course, where are we gonna go? Popularity. I like to be popular. Actually, do you like... We like Woohoo even better than that, so there we go. We're going to go for that. It's actually called Woohoo now, as opposed to The Sims, where it was, what was it, just Get Frisky or something? Yeah, outgoing, active, that works. A little less neat, perhaps a little, not nice, playful. I like to play around. Okay, this is the family. I can be married, would be intriguing, but we're not going to do that. And there we go. We have a nice, happy family here with Jokester Douche over here with the Lazy Game Review shirt on. Oh, man. I actually made that, didn't I? I'm having second thoughts. All right, so let's choose a lot to go into. I forgot about all this junk. Oh, this is fantastic. Let's start with a... let's do a house this time, because... Oh, right next to the Calientes. Those tramps. Yeah, we're gonna go and visit them at some point.
Let's see if we can, have some fun.
Alright, so... Yes, so many additions with this one. I don't even know where to start, so I guess we'll just talk about them when we get to them, but, yeah, I mean, the aging up was a huge, huge thing, I know, for me. It was one of the things I wanted so much with the original game. I mean, it was like you were a prison of your own life. You just kind of were one age, and your kids never aged up. At least I don't remember them ever aging up. And with this, you know, you have different life states that you go through. It was just awesome. You could age up, have kids, they aged up, have different generations. It was sweet. Plus, you also have all these wants and fears, which, that's nice. You can lock them in place, but you can't get rid of them. That kind of sucks. At least I can't get rid of them. I don't know. And you also have fears. Never really liked these. It really made the game quite annoying, because it's quite easy to be rejected for a flirt or pass out, especially if you're Duke Nukem. So you'd often end up with, like, the sim shrink or whatever coming in to, diagnose you. Whatever.
Let's get a double bed. I'm gonna put that right here.
And that cost money. So, cheating is fun. At least when you're doing a video like this. There we go. We got money. Let's see. We have a pinball table. We're going to put that outside because pinball is loud.
Put it right here.
I'm going to put a remote control car over there and a game console. Nowhere, actually. We're going to put that somewhere else. Yes, that's all we need. What else do we have here? We have things. We have comfort and surfaces. Plumbing.
I got some plumbing right here.
So we don't need any more of that. Duke has ample plumbing. we need a fridge. Fridges are good. The ever-present food processor, because Sims suck. We'll leave that there, because hopefully their house will burn down. That'd be hilarious. Coffee, now we don't need that. Microwave. Don't know if they can use it there, but that's fine. Let's see here. We have crappy artwork that's awful. Don't need any of that. Curtains. Wow, what a waste of time. It's curtains. Let's just put them outside. See, that makes sense to me. There we go. Oh, yeah. That's a nice house. This music, man. It was so much cheerier and happier than The Sims 1. Or, I don't know, maybe a little more hyper is the word I'm looking for, but just as memorable at the same time. I need some form of entertainment here. I've got this nice old computer. That'd be good. We're gonna put this right here. I always hated that desk.
So that's why I'm using it. I'm trying to get over my fear.
And let's put a bunch of chairs around it just in case we have a party. Yeah, right. Yeah.
Looks good.
So, Duke Nukem. Alright, so you see his want for a double bed has been fulfilled. And he now wants a stereo. This guy probably wants a new face, but that's not in here. Well, get a job in the science. You might get a new face in there, or medicine. He does want a new face, so there we go. What does he fear? Fire, getting sick, and using a public toilet. Well, that's quite the fear right there.
All right. So what do you think of this crappy desk?
I think it's crap. Then again, I have a red nose. Rudolph, the lazy game reviewer, doesn't like fire or public bathrooms.
But I'm Duke Nukem, so I don't give a crap.
That's right. Let's play some shark pinball. Freaking why I... Yeah, I don't know. Huh. Maybe your nose will give you... Oh, you're already doing that. Well, see, there you go. Yeah, his nose gives him the ability to remote control cars better, because it acts kind of as an antenna, if I was completely honest. Oh, yeah, that's definitely antenna territory right there. That beard is just barely covering up the teeth popping out of his cheeks, but, you know, gets the job done.
Hey, who are you?
Probably underage, so watch out. Greet Amy Jones. Get over here. Let's talk. Let's find somebody. Oh, you wanted to meet somebody new, right? Here's somebody. Are you new? Tip? Oh.
Oh, not that kind of person.
All right, so yeah, they do still disappear out there. So, even though you can... Actually, you can't. Say. Yeah, well, I guess you can. You can kind of see other lots are here, but you don't actually see them. Oh, man. I choked on my own description. You can see the other lots, but you can't actually see the other lots. That wasn't added until a later expansion, or update, or whatever. And you can't actually just walk to them like you can in The Sims 3. That was... The big open neighborhood was really a big Sims 3 addition. So, with this, if you wanted to go somewhere, you would have to call them up, or... just go there, I think. I don't know. Let's see. How exactly does that happen? I haven't played the vanilla version of this game in, yeah, frick, probably since, what, 2005? So, don't exactly remember the limitations of this one. Well, that's okay. Hey, you're new. Let's meet you. Stop walking. Why is your name... What? Did you shoo them away? I don't want to meet you. That's Duke Nukem for you. He... Man. Man. I'd rather drive this car. He looked like an 18-year-old Duke Nukem or something. I don't know. It doesn't quite look right in Sims 2, but... He would look better if I had some better clothes for him. If anybody has any better Duke Nukem clothing, that'd be great. Alright, let's get you guys out of here. Of course you're on a computer, aren't you? What are you going to play here? The Sim OS. Oh, something with a CD. Some high-tech crap. Oh, you're going to play the operating system. That needed a CD, I'm sure. You can chat with people, send emails, play 6-3, find a job, write a novel. Let's find a job, because you don't need one. What kind of jobs are out there for a mohawked guy with a red nose and teeth coming out of his face? Business career as a mailroom technician. Well, yeah, somebody, someplace where nobody will see you. That seems ideal. There you go. Duke Nukem, on the other hand, needs to get out of here and meet some people and get it on. Get a job in the slacker career. You know, what if I don't want that? Oh, here we go. Wait, no, keep it. Well, I guess you can't get rid of it. I think it, what is it, refresh every day or something, I think is how that works. I suppose we'll see. Yes, and these points you can get for actually fulfilling these, like 500 because we got that bed. So eventually you can get your little lifetime reward kind of things here, or aspiration rewards in this one. So you've got money tree, noodle soother, the homogeneous smart milk, cool shades. The shades are so cool. Love tub. And career rewards, which I don't think I ever got any of these. Because I was awful at careers in this game for some reason. Not entirely sure why. Another thing I'm awful at least at the moment, because I don't want to mess with it, is actually designing houses. It's a big part of it, though. I probably designed more houses in this one than I ever did in The Sims 1. It really has a great house design system here. But, let's see, where do we do this? Not that I know what I'm doing. What the frick? Why isn't it doing anything? Okay, there's that, there's that, there's the hand, there's the design tool. Huh. Yeah, I'm completely baffled. It will let me place things. Like there's a phone or whatever, and then I go in here. Doesn't do crap. Nothing with the design tool, this doesn't work. Nothing. Night and day works. Well, why? Why? I don't know. I'm just gonna let it go. Oh, hey, here's someone. Oh, it's the Tramp Sisters. Nina and Dina. I have, done interesting things with them over the years of playing this game. I think everyone has, because they're pretty much omnipresent. They're like the de facto starting ladies of the town. Yeah. Flirt? Well, I can do that. Ah, hey! She likes me. Well, why wouldn't she? Let's tell a joke. You can play my pinball. All right. Yeah, that was a real funny one, right? That was great. Now, let's get it on.
Oh, great. Can't do that yet. Oh, we could admire you. Well, there we go.
You need to do something with your life. Oh, yeah. Play games. That's what a lazy game reviewer does. Hey, no. Come back. You need to stop playing with your toys, Duke, and go play with a woman. Seriously. Get over here. Come on. Is that really all we can do? What is this crap? Brag, it probably doesn't go over so well. Nope, it does not. Well, let's just chat then. Because I don't remember how to do relationships. Oh, come on, you like me? Well, let's, like, do something else then. Dude, really? Oh, great. Look at the camera like that. How about a nice friendly hug? Oh, you didn't like that either. Well, dang it. I'll buy a stereo to make you feel better. There you go, Duke. I feel great. Buy a bar? Okay. Let's just buy Duke's happiness. That sounds about right. Why the bars? How's that? That's a nice one. Looks kind of like a bar. I don't know how many bar stools. What a pile of crap. Yeah, put that there. Let's see whatever. Alright. Okay, so that's got him in a slightly better mood, I guess. Gain a cooking skill point. Oh, look. You know, you're sitting at the desk. That's how nice. Okay, that's the laugh of desperation right there. Somebody's actually talking to me with this nose and these cheek teeth. Well, I'm going to tell you another joke. You're going to laugh so hard, you're going to... Anyways. Hey, it's somebody else. Let's, try our chances. You know, if she likes me that much, I don't see why she's not more, susceptible to my charms. I got charms of steel. There's got to be some more, something here. Alright, tickle. Nothing worked with you. See, we just gotta, like, go out and... I don't even know. Ain't got time for this. Alright, let's get out of here. Let's go to... somewhere. Let's just call the emergency. Let's see. Let's call the cops. Burglars can be dangerous. Hey, look! All these weird people in my house! What? 500? There was an emergency! There's people not giving in to my flirtation! That's a crime! Alright, well, let's get out of here then. Let's, transportation, yes. There we go. Let's invite somebody to the community lot. We're going to... What? Meet somebody? Yeah, you have! Look, there's like three people here and one freak. Fine, let's go alone.
Going at it alone.
Yeah, let's go. Multiple Sims, why not? Yeah, let's go. Stop cooking food. Now, I don't know who this multiple Sims thing is going to be bringing with me, but, well, I suppose we'll find out. Hopefully it's not Freak Face, but, well, you never know. So, where we got to go? We got 250 Main Street. This is a pool, a park, a business, and... a boutique for the fashion-conscious sim. Oh, let's go there. I need some fashion. Maybe that'll get me some more luck with the ladies. After all, you do look like kind of a tool in that outfit. Duke. That's Not exactly what I would... Anyway. Let's see. It's nighttime, so that means nighttime is upon us. Oh, what? Both of them? Okay. Well, you can go over here and stand on the flowers. No, not you, Duke. Well, you can go too. No, you can't. No, you can go over here. Let's see. We're going to talk to Angel here. I got a captive audience now. Yeah, that's right.
So how about them awards? They're a pile of crap.
Movies, music, blah, 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 blah. Oh, whatever. Let's try on some clothes.
Sounds like a good idea.
Okay. Well, why not? And that. There we go. Oh, well, that was helpful. Well. Okay. Never mind then. That was completely pointless. Wow, what a useless little lot. I mean, seriously. I you know, that's probably like the only place you can get clothes, but still. What a useless little lot. I'm freaking dumb. I'm gonna go swing over here because I'm a swinger. Yay. That was great. Oh, let's get out of here. Duke, you smell like crap again. We're gonna go home. Actually, we're gonna go to another lot because you smell like butt. So, I don't know. Might attract some bears or something. That would be great. Actually, yeah. This game could use random bear maulings. Like, that would be fantastic. Smell like crap? Get eaten by a bear. If that ain't encouragement for good hygiene, I don't know what is. Hopefully 290 Main will have a little bit better, I don't know. Something. Okay, well, at least this place looks a little more substantial. It may not actually be. It's pretty much all a facade. Well, you can buy something, though. Oh, yeah, that's right. You could buy magazines for no friggin' reason. Isn't that great? Beyond belief, yes. I don't believe it either. Let's see. We have an arcade. Oh, yeah, let's buy some games. I do miss doing this, though. We got, like, these, look, they look like PSP games, but they're PC games. We got The Sims busting out, SimCity 4 Rush Hour, and that's it. Oh, that's great. I think they added some more games in the later expansions. I forget what I already got. I guess, what? Yeah, let's try something else. After you're done eating that hot dog. Yeah, we're gonna SimCity 4 Rush Hour. You play the expansion pack without the full game. That's incredible.
On Duke Nukem, I can play the expansion on its own.
And in here, we have food. Oh, yeah, you can go friggin' grocery shopping. Why? What a strange kind of mechanic to the game. Although it's interesting, it adds to the realism, but it's kind of like, you know, washing clothes in The Sims 3. I guess it's nice, but it's, you know, as an option. But here, it's not an option. Like, you have to go get food. You'll run out. Well, that's a pile of junk. What are you eating this time? That's, eat. You're eating eat?
Mmm, that's some good eat.
Oh, they look like hot dogs. Oh, they're hot dogs. All right. Well then, this is great. Let's go home and see if we can find somebody to do. Or something to occupy our time with. Yes. Oh, there was What's-Her-Face for a split second there. Yeah, this game really, really came alive with the expansions, of course. There's still quite a bit to do, but what are you still doing here? Brandy? Being a slob? Maybe you'll have better luck. You probably will. I mean, come on. Telling jokes with that face? That's bound to get a laugh. Okay, well, He's just, legs got run over by a taxi and passed out, so I guess the joke's not happening.
Yeah, the joke's on you, buddy.
What, man? Go to sleep or something. Or... Okay, well, literally, yeah, just go to sleep right there. So, going to bed. What? Relax? No, sleep. Oh, whoa, yeah, I wasn't paying attention to the needs.
Ha! Your Sims still have needs. That's
expected, but just forgot about it.
Wake up. Go to sleep.
In your underwear or pajamas. Yes, you gotta have choices. The Sims 2 gives them to you. Let's see if anything's working again now that I went to a community lot. Nope, still not working. What the balls?
Ugh, I want some wallpaper.
I can't do it. Screw that. Oh well. Best we can do is some kind of tacky artwork right here. Oh yeah, there you go. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that's tacky. Wonderful. Duke is gonna be so happy when he wakes up.
I love flamingos.
Everybody's sitting everywhere but the computer. I think that's great. Hey, play some SimCity, man. Let's see, play SimCity 4 Rush Hour. That's a good game. Yeah. So yeah, he's making a new city, starting off there, got some advisor. Dang, he's really getting into those advisor screens.
Oh, this advising is so good.
Oh, whoa, what a wonderful thing to zoom in on there. Hmm. What, you can't, what, really? Then go and eat somewhere else. Oh no, you want to cook. Oh, hmm. Alright, so there's no hand of God in this one. That sucks. Can't just pick him up on my own. I guess you gotta go and cook everything. LGR has a job. Well, this is gonna be great. You have no sleep. Go to the job anyway. No, just go ahead. At least take a shower first. There you go. That'll wake you up. Except it won't. You have teeth in your cheeks. Yeah, go over here. No. Have a drink first. You're going to need it. Drink from the bottle. That's a nice option. And the job's right there. He's like, you know what? Screw that. I need this. Okay. All right. That's like a fifth of vodka right there. Let's go. You're going to need it. Oh, you poor sap. Duke is still having problems. Oh, the pathfinding issues in this game. My goodness. Just do something with it. Jeez, put this somewhere else. Why the frick is that there anyway? Okay, let's put that over there. I don't know what that is or what this is. All right.
Leopard bottom. Let's cook this.
And it smells like crap and you're cooking it. That's great. Go ahead. Huh. You know what? Let's just cook a bunch of things. See what happens. Actually, no. Screw that. Don't get it. No, don't get it. Oh, I want to burn the house down. Go over here and don't get it. Now, what you need to do is make an airplane. That's the solution. Don't worry about your pits, man. Nobody's smelling them. You're not getting any action anyway. It doesn't matter. Just make airplanes. Oh, a letter falls in the ground. Okay, whatever. Act quickly and take investment opportunity himself. Pfft, yeah, screw the boss. Oh, choking hazard. Friggin' kids choking on crap. Losing my investments. Alright, this has got to be prime fire right here anytime now. Make sure I don't have any smoke alarms. Nope. None of that. Yeah, that's an entertaining friggin' airplane right there. Oh yeah, there we go. Yay! It's everyone's favorite disaster, fire! Well, next to leaving the Sims in the pool, or locking them in a room, or electrocution, or any number of other wonderful things. Yes, go in there, look at the fire. I'm content to just let this burn down, honestly. It's getting rid of half this crap. This place is awful. Oh no, whoa, that... Well...
I'm on fire.
Well, Duke Nukem didn't last long this time, did he? Grimmy's all like, you know what, that's unfortunate. I mean, you know, I was expecting him to at least last until friggin' university, but no.
So yeah, I've got a Duke Nukem here. What should we do with this? Okay. Alright, well.
I guess that's that. Duke Nukem is a pile of ashes on the floor. The combination of that scene with that music, that's fantastic. Oh, you're just gonna... Okay, so Sim went crazy. I suppose it's about time for the shrink to show up. Oh, that's right, you have a fear of fire. That's a problem. Guy always reminded me of Will Wright with crazier hair. No, oh, like mid-90s Will Wright. That awesome stash. Suddenly, having teeth in your face doesn't feel so bad. And the fact that your friend and house burned down. That's cool. Oh, alright, yeah, just pass out right there. I'd say this right here, nice productive first day to The Sims 2. Oh, put the fire out already. No, just answer the phone. You never know, it could be the fireman. Oh, come on, seriously? You too? Put it out. Oh, just pass out. Fine, that works. okay, now, just put the fire out. Well, The Sims 2, everyone. stay tuned for all the expansions. I don't know how I'm going to handle the stuff packs yet. But, there you go. The Sims 2. Thanks for watching.